the more people are involved in civil society organizations, the more empowered the society becomes. Yeah. So kalau kita dapat libatkan ramai lagi, yeah, the more empowered that becomes. That's the reason why you see this protest happening actually. It's about empowering the people. And that is why you see changes. That is why you see the impact of GE13 for that matter. And arguably people say, bersih, GMI, ini semua buat kerja bagi pihak parti politik. Dekat mereka menang dalam pilihan raya kerana kerja-kerja yang dibuat oleh civil society. And we kadang-kadang kita claim lah. Kita claim lah, kenalah claim. But orang tak bagi kredit, kita credit ourselves. Because kita kata, ah tengok. Tapi parti politik kalau lupakan kami, siap. We will go down again and make you fall pula. So, parti politik pun kena jaga-jaga lah. That's the warning that we, lot of civil society give to not just Barisan Nasional but also to Pakatan Rakyat for that matter. So it is very very powerful that you are empowering the people, kan? So these influencing factors, democracy, politics, freedom, social, education, media, economy, legislation, all of this, they influence civil society. Kalau ada freedom, ada democracy, civil society works. Tapi kalau you sekat, it may work better because you have kena sekat, you akan berusaha bersungguh-sungguh. Tetapi ada juga civil society yang okeylah, balik. Nak kena sembuh kita balik. We don't want to take the risk. Ada. Itu pun ada juga. Tapi ada juga yang sebaliknya, lagi sembuh, lagi mahu kita pergi. So, these are the influencing factors. Kadang-kadang social economy status. It affects the civil society. Kebanyakannya dalam civil society yang through my experience lah, yang banyak involved ni, dia banyak juga orang-orang yang susah, orang-orang yang daif, people who actually had to go struggle through their lives. Yeah, satu rumah duduk keluarga mungkin anak 5-6, rumah tu ada 2 bilik saja, anak dah besar-besar. Yeah, but they don't have any other means. Yeah, itu sahajalah pendapatan dia. So in order for them to get away from that, sometimes what they do is they need to raise their voice, raise their rights. So they became agents of change in civil society. Yeah, because of social status. Tapi ada juga because of social status tu menyebabkan crime rate naik, gejala sosial bertambah. That is another angle of it at the same time. Yeah? Jadi ini semua adalah influencing factors. But so as far as civil society, the role, these are some of the rules. Number one, third force. I mentioned it also this morning. The check and balance. Yeah, you know, there's the government. You know, there's the political party. But you also need civil society to play that role as the check and balance. Same thing like what MAFRA, Malaysians for Free and Fair Elections, did. However, the sad story about it is, kita cuba untuk daftar sebagai civil society, but we were denied because they say there's already SPR. SPR dah ada, jadi tak perlu lagi ada MAFREL. But it's two different rules sebenarnya. Kalau SPR, dia laksanakan pilihan raya. Kalau MAFREL, dia mengawasi pilihan raya. Jadi two different rules. Tapi they do not understand that. So, this is the challenge. Yeah, this is the challenge. Tapi kita kena, as civil society, you need to have that, play that role as check and balance. And when you play that role as check and balance, sometimes you will face challenges. Yeah, because apa? Kita tegur. Tetapi tegur ni pun, oh ni panjang. Tegur ni pun banyak cara. Some people say, just kritik saja. You know, you just kritik, blah. Kritik, blah. I mean, that's easy way out. What we did, yeah, a lot of civil society, yang successful civil society organizations, they provide recommendations, constructive criticism. Then they give proposals, bagi paperwork lagi. Despite the fact that this paper might not even be looked at upon by the powers that be. Yeah, tapi ada, constructive. Itu yang menyebabkan orang takut. Orang rasa, eh, dengan main-main ni civil society ni. Yeah? Walaupun tak cukup orang tak ni, tapi tengok proposal, hoof, power, colour lagi semua. So, jangan apa, underestimate the power of civil society, role of civil society. Empower the society, promote participation. And then cultivate civilized values. So it's not just a matter of demanding things, but it's actually a tool for tarbiyah, a tool for education. Yeah, I learned a lot because I was involved in civil society. I became almost like a lawyer because I was involved in civil society. I need to understand the law. I need to understand what laws are violating my rights. I need to understand which law are good law. Jadi I became macam lawyer. Orang pun tanya, Tuan Syed, you memang belajar law? Tak ada. I did not study law. But I became that. Simply because we wanted to ensure that we'll be able to give the right messages, educate the public, the general mass, saying the right things to them. Kita tak nak tipu. Yeah, kita tak nak tipu. Kita nak educate. Bila dia nampak ikhlas kita, jujur kita, bersungguh-sungguh kita, you'll get that buy-in. Yeah, insyaAllah people will come and they see that, and that you became the role model and you cultivate those civilized values. And then lobby and advocacy. Lobby and advocacy. Government tak ada buat lobby kecuali dekat UN saja. UN they need to lobby. Tapi dekat dalam negara, dalam Malaysia, dia tak payah lobby. Itu bukan kerja dia. Yeah? Advocacy, dia tak payah buat advocacy. Semua dah dituliskan, semua menurut perintah. Kalau dia hantar surat, mereka pernah buat je. Yeah? But it's different with civil society. You need to struggle. You need to demand, you need to call for things. That is what is considered as lobby dengan advocacy. And then last but not least is protecting democratic sphere. Kalau yang ini, you serahkan hanya kepada parti politik, boleh, ya. Tetapi parti itu memang kena orang parti yang memang bercita-cita untuk buat perubahan yang betul. But there's always interest behind it. Ya, with due respect to politicians, ada politicians ni? Tak ada politicians. All of us are actually politicians. Kita tak perasan je. Ya, with due respect to politicians, you cannot avoid making that you cannot avoid having that interest of the political party. Yeah? Jadi siapa yang kena protect the democratic space, the sphere of democracy ni, is actually civil society. Kalau tak ada democratic space sebenarnya, dianya menjejaskan pilihan raya, menjejaskan kempen dalam parti, dalam pilihan raya, proses pilihan raya. So you need to create that democratic space. So these are the rules of some of it. Yeah, some of it. Sahaja. Sebenarnya ada lagi. Tapi I think these are enough. Okay. Now, despite the fact that you have all these rules of society, sebenarnya dalam banyak-banyak civil society, mereka ada four common principles. Around four common principles. Number one is good governance. Number two is justice. Number three is freedom. And number four is basic rights. Dia can fall within these four things. Yeah? As long as you work along these lines, then you will be able to actually garner support. You will be able to also send the correct messages. Tak kira lah ikram pun. Lebih-lebih lagi ikram. Yeah? Because these are principles of justice, freedom. Semua adalah prinsip yang dibawa oleh Islam. Yeah? Kita sebut tentang makasih syariah. Kita sebut tentang nak bawa kebaikan. Bring goodness. Enjoy what is good, forbid what is bad, evil. That is all about ensuring that we have these good principles being practiced. Okay.